You'll recall what we had done in Richardson's extrapolation in module 6 was we computed the integral for h, we recomputed the integral for h by 2 and used these two integrals in order to compute a better value or a more accurate value of integral. So, and we had said I nu was going to be equal to 2 to the power n multiplied by I h by 2 minus I h divided by 2 to the power n minus 1. Okay. So, this is what we had derived in the previous module. We are essentially going to go over almost exact same derivation for Richardson's extrapolation in case of the Runge-Kutta methods or in case of ODE solution methods. Okay. So, the idea is this, is what we want to do is we want to get yi plus 1 as accurate as desired. What do we mean by as accurate as desired is that we need to define what tolerance value that we need. Okay. So, we need to define and we will call this, as we have been doing in the past, we will call this as epsilon tol, that is the desired tolerance value or desired error value that we will give. Okay. Now, in Richardson's extrapolation, before going to and talking about this particular tolerance values and so on, we will go over this Richardson's extrapolation. The idea is this, the true value yi plus 1, the true value is going to be equal to yi, that is compute, or yi plus 1 which is computed numerically, plus some constant c1 multiplied by h to the power 5 for the RK4 method. Okay. This is what essentially we had written over here. I have just rewritten this particular equation over here. For RK4 we have the true value yi plus 1 bar equal to yi plus 1 plus c1 h to the power 5. Okay. What I will do is I will just modify this a little bit in line with what we had done over here, and I will put in bracket yi plus 1 h plus c1 h to the power 5. So, this is using the RK4 method once going from yi to yi plus 1. Okay. This is what we get. Now, let us redo the same thing going from yi to yi plus 1 in 2 steps. In this case, the step size is going to be h by 2. So, we will go from yi to yi plus half, and from yi plus half, we will go to yi plus 1 computed at with a step size of h by 2. Okay. So, this particular method when we use, this method is going to be more accurate, as we have been seeing all throughout, this method is going to be more accurate in giving us the value of yi plus 1 compared to the method in which we are going to use one single step to go from yi to yi plus 1. Now, there will be error that is going to be associated with this particular step as well as an error that is associated with this particular step. So, we will have our yi plus half bar is going to be equal to yi plus half plus c1 h by 2 to the power 5. Okay. So, this is going to be our true value of yi plus half. Yi plus 1 bar is going to be equal to the value computed at yi plus 1 from this particular guy plus the error that we will get at yi plus 1. Okay. So, now this error is also going to propagate into the future. So without going actually into any of the numerical complexities into this, I will write this yi plus 1 is going to be approximately of the form of yi plus 1 plus 2 times c1 h by 2 to the power 5. The first c1 h by 2 to the power 5 comes because of we go from yi to yi plus half. The second c1 h by 2 to the power 5 comes because of the local truncation error going from yi plus 1 to yi plus half to yi plus 1. Okay. So this is essentially how we will write our yi plus 1 when we go for the true value of yi plus 1 related to yi plus 1 computed by taking 2 steps. Okay. And because it is computed by taking 2 steps, I will put in the bracket yi plus 1 h by 2. Okay. As I have we had done before, we will multiply this particular equation by 2 to the power 4, not 2 to the power 5, but 2 to the power 4, just as we had done in the integration method. We will multiply it by 2 to the power 4 and then subtract this equation from this equation. So we will get 2 to the power 4 y I plus 1 equal to 2 to the power 4 multiplied by y I h by 2 plus c1 h to the power 5. So we had 2 times c1, we had 2 times c1 h by 2 to the power 5. When we multiplied this with 2 to the power 4, all this got cancelled away and we were left with c1 h to the power 5, and that is what I have written over here, as well as yi plus 1, I forgot the bar over here, is going to be yi computed with h plus c1 h to the power 5. Okay. And of course, there are c2 h to the power 6, c3 h to the power 7 terms also, and so on over here, which are not going to get cancelled, because we will have, we will essentially have plus c2 h to the power 6 by 2, and here we will have c2 h to the power 6. This is the term that I had not written down earlier. Okay. And now when we subtract these two equations and then divide throughout by 2 to the power 4 minus 1, we are going to get yi plus 1 is going to be equal to 2 to the power 4 yi h by 2 minus yi h divided by 2 to the power 4 minus 1. Okay. So this is essentially what we are going to get. Okay. We can write this as 16 times yi plus 1, I should have here, 16 times yi plus 1 h by 2, I can write this as 15 times yi plus 1 h by 2 minus plus yi plus 1 h by 2 minus yi plus 1 h divided by 15, and which we will be able to write it as yi plus 1 computed at h by 2 plus delta divided by 15, where delta is defined as the difference yi plus 1 h by 2 minus yi plus 1 h. Okay. And this is going to be our final result. Okay. And similar derivations can be done for the RK2 method also, and for RK2 method we are going to get, so for RK4, Okay. Now how this 15 comes in? It comes in 2 to the power 4 minus 1. Likewise, this 3 comes in because it's going to be 2 to the power 2 minus 1. The exponent is the order of accuracy minus 1. The local truncation error is h to the power 5 accurate over here, h to the power 3 accurate over here. So the exponent for 2 is going to be 1 less than the local truncation error accuracy. So it's 2 to the power 2 minus 1, that becomes 3, and the overall accuracy of this method increases by one order. So it is increased by from h cubed to h to the power 4. Okay, and this is for the RK2 method, this is for the RK4 method that we get. Okay, so these are the results of Richardson's extrapolation.